Hello everyone, in this video we'll see some of the example problems related to trickling filter design. Before that we can see some of this data which is used for the design of trickling filter. So it is given for standard rate filter and high rate filter, so we can compare also. The first is depth of media. So it is between 1.8 to 2.4 meter in case of standard rate filter, and it is between 1.2 to 1.8 meter for high rate filter. So obviously in case of high rate filter we can take a smaller depth of media. Next is hydraulic loading, which is given in meter cube per day per meter square. So it is between 1 to 4 for standard rate filter, and it is between 10 to 30 for high rate filter. So obviously hydraulic loading we can increase in high rate filter, so that is why it is more here. But this hydraulic loading includes the sewage flow through recirculation also. That is, if this is your trickling filter, after that we provide a secondary sedimentation tank and before that primary sedimentation tank. So some of the flow comes back to trickling filter. Let's say this is your raw sewage, flow of raw sewage, and the returning, the recirculated is QR. So in hydraulic loading it will include QS as well as QR. Next is your organic loading. It is given in kilogram per day per meter cube. So it is between 0.08 to 0.32 for standard rate filter, and it is between 0.32 to 1 for high rate filter. So this is also higher in high rate filter, but it excludes the BOD of recirculation. That is, whatever this flow QR is there, it will contain some BOD also. So when we talk about the organic loading, this BOD which is there in the recirculated flow, it is not included. Whereas in hydraulic loading, flow from raw sewage as well as this recirculated sewage is included. But in organic loading, only the BOD which is there in this raw sewage, it will be included. Next is recirculation ratio. So it is not applicable in standard rate filter because no recirculation is there. And in high rate filter, this ratio is between 1 to 4. So this is some of the data or the design data. Now let's see the problem. So first one says, determine the size of a high rate trickling filter for the following data. Sewage flow is equal to 5 MLD. Recirculation ratio, that is R, is 1.5. BOD of raw sewage is 230 mg per liter. Let's say this is YI. BOD removal in PST is 30%. This is will not be right. So BOD removal in PST is 30%, and final effluent BOD desired is 25 milligrams per liter. So here we have to find out the size of a high rate trickling filter. That means if we can find out the dia and depth we can assume, already we have seen some ranges. So with the help of that we can assume the depth, and if we can find the dia, that means you have to find the area and volume. So for the volume, if you remember the formula for efficiency, this NRC formula, the equation is 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 divided by organic loading, that is BOD load in kg, divided by volume into recirculation factor. So here it includes, this formula includes volume also. So with the help of this formula, we can obtain volume. But for that we should know the efficiency. So there is one more formula for efficiency, that is BOD of influent, BOD of effluent divided by BOD of influent into 100. This can also give you the efficiency. So here we know the BOD of raw sewage, we know the BOD of final effluent, and BOD removal in PST is also given. So we can find out what is the BOD that is applied to trickling filter. So here it is your PST, and at this point BOD is 230 milligrams per liter. Some clarification is done, that is 30% is done in PST, then remaining is applied to your trickling filter. So here this is your YI, and after that there will be a secondary sedimentation tank, and then the BOD at this point is your Y naught. So that is given as 25 milligrams per liter. So first of all let's calculate this YI. So YI would be 30% is removed in PST, so 70% will be remaining. 0.7 into 230 is the remaining BOD. So that is equal to 161 milligrams per liter. Now we can find out the efficiency. We know, Y naught also we know, that is 25 milligrams per liter. So E is equal to 161 minus 25 divided by 161 into 100. That is equal to 84.47%. Now we know the efficiency. Apart from that, we should know this BOD applied in kilograms per day for this formula, as well as the recirculation factor. So for the recirculation factor, recirculation ratio is given. So we can find that out. First of all, let's calculate this. BOD load on filter in kilograms per day. So for that, we know this 161 milligrams per liter is applied. 161, so we can write 161 into 10 power minus 6 kilograms per liter into what is the sewage flow. So this is per liter, and 5 mld is the sewage flow. So that is 5 into 10 to the power 6 liters per day. So that will give you 161 into 5, that is 805 kilograms per day. This is the BOD which is applied on the filter in kilograms per day. So W is also known to us. Now we can find out the recirculation factor, that is the formula is 1 plus R divided by 1 plus 0.1 into R whole square. So R is given as recirculation ratio is 1.5. So we can put here 1 plus 1.5 divided by 1 plus 0.1 into 1.5 whole square, and this is equal to 1.89. Now we can use this formula of efficiency, this one, NRC formula. So using this formula, here E is equal to 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 under root of W, that is 805, divided by V, that we have to calculate, into F, that is 1.89. So E, how much did we calculate the efficiency? It is equal to 84.47. So from here, under root of 805 divided V into 1.89, this is equal to 0.4178. And from here you can calculate the V, that is volume, and it is equal to 2439.5 meter cube. So this is your volume of the filter. Now here depth is not given, so depth of filter we can assume, depth of filter, so it is a high rate filter. The range is between 1.2 to 1.8 meter. You can choose anything. I am taking 1.8 meter. So from here, area of filter is equal to 2439.5 divided by 1.8, and that is equal to 1355.28 meter square. So we provide a circular filter. If we are providing a circular filter, then we can find out the dia with the help of this area. Pi by 4 into D square is equal to this area. And from here, if you calculate, the dia is equal to 41.5 meter. So that way we have found out the size of the filter which we had to find in the question. Let's see the next question now. It says a single stage filter is designed for an organic loading of 10,000 kg of POD in raw sewage per hectare meter per day with a recirculation ratio of 1.2. This filter treats a flow of 4 mld of raw sewage. So sewage flow is given, that is equal to 4 mld, and the BOD in raw sewage is equal to, it is given as 220 milligrams per liter. Determine the strength of the effluent, and primary sedimentation tank removes 35% of BOD in raw sewage. And initially it was given that it is designed for this organic loading in raw sewage, that is design organic loading is equal to 10,000 kilogram per hectare meter per day. That we can write as 1 kilogram per meter cube per day, because 1 hectare is equal to 10 to the power 4 meter square. So replacing that, we can get this. So BOD in raw sewage is given. So from here we can find out the total BOD in kilogram per day in raw sewage, kilograms per day. That is equal to 220 into 10 to the power minus 6 kilogram per liter multiplied by the flow of sewage, that is 4 into 10 to the power 6 liters per day. So this will give in kilograms per day, and that is equal to 880 kilograms per day. This is the total BOD in raw sewage, and this is also given that this filter is designed for this organic loading of raw sewage. So we can divide the two and find out the volume of the filter. Volume of filter is equal to 880 divided by, that is in kilograms per day, and this is total BOD and this is the loading rate. So we can divide it 1 kilogram per meter cube per day. So your volume of filter from here is equal to 880 meter cube. Now what do we have to find out here? We have to find out the strength of effluent. So what is the BOD rate, I mean BOD concentration in the effluent? So first of all, we have to find out the efficiency of the filter. E is equal to 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 under root of W upon VF. We know the volume of the filter. F we will have to find out. R is given, I think it is 1.2. So with that, F we can calculate 1 plus 1.2 divided by 1 plus 0.1 into 1.2 whole square, and that is equal to 1.754. F is also known to us now. So W we have to find out. So total BOD load in, this is given in raw sewage, and apart from that we have been given that this PST removes 35% of BOD in raw sewage. So 65% only will be remaining. So BOD applied to filter is equal to 0.65 into 880, and that is equal to 572 kilograms per day. Now don't confuse it that here we did not multiply it with 0.65, this organic loading, because it is given that the design, I mean this filter is designed based upon the BOD in raw sewage. So this is what we have used for the, I mean for finding out the volume of the filter. So now W also we know, F also we know, V also we know, so we can find out the efficiency. That is equal to 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 multiplied by 572 divided by 880 into F is 1.754, and so from here efficiency of the filter is 78.87%. So what does this efficiency tells us? It tells us that 78.87% of BOD that was applied to filter, BOD applied to filter is removed. Then how much will be the remaining BOD? It will be 1 minus 0.7887 multiplied by what was the BOD applied? It was 572 kilograms per day. So BOD remaining, this is equal to your BOD remaining, and the value is 120.864 kilograms per day. Now we can convert this into concentration. So BOD concentration, this is the BOD remaining in effluent. So we can convert it in BOD concentration, that is in milligrams per liter. So 120.864, this is in kilograms per day, divided by the total volume, I mean total sewage flow, that is equal to 4 MLD, 4 into 10 to the power 6 liter per day, and this is in kilograms per day, so we can write it in milligrams per day. So that is 10 to 10 to the power 6 into milligrams, and this unit is now milligrams per day. So per day will cancel out and it will come out in milligrams per liter. That is equal to 30.22 milligrams per liter. So this is the BOD concentration in effluent. Now let's say instead of single stage filter, we have used two stage filter, and total volume remains fixed. Total volume is same, and each stage has half of the total volume. So volume of stage 1 V1, let's say it is 880 by 2 is equal to V2, and that is 440 meter cube. And recirculation ratio, let's say R is still 1.2, so F will also remain same, that is we calculated 1.754. and BOD loading we'll have to see. So now let's see, if we are using two stage filter, then what is the BOD of effluent? Now we can see the strength of the effluent. So let's say let's find out for the first stage filter. So the efficiency is 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 under root of W upon Vf. So BOD applied, the value of W for first stage we calculated, that will remain same, 572 kilograms per day. Other things also we know, that is 100 upon 1 plus 0.44 into 572 divided by V is how much? 440 it is now, and F is 1.754. So using this, the efficiency for first stage filter comes out as 72.53%. Now we can use this to find out the BOD remaining in the second stage. That will be W1 into 1 minus E. This is your W1. So that is 572 into 1 minus 0.7253. And from here, W2, that is the BOD load for second stage, it is equal to 157.13 kilograms per day. So we can find out the efficiency for the second stage now, that is 100 divided by 1 plus 0.44 divided by 1 minus E. So E is 0.7253 multiplied by under root of, so this is the formula, let me write it once, 1 plus 0.44 divided by 1 minus E under root of W2 upon V2 into F2, we can say. So E here is, small e here is capital E by 100, simply 0.7253. So BOD loading is 157.13 divided by volume is 440 and F is 1.754. So from here, the efficiency of second stage is 58.05%. Now we can find out what is the BOD remaining in the effluent after second stage. BOD load in effluent after second stage, it is equal to 1 minus 0.5805 into, what was the BOD applied here? It was 157.13. From here, this BOD load remaining is equal to 65.92 kilograms per day. So this is the final BOD load that is remaining. Now we can convert it into concentration. So BOD concentration in effluent, or we can write it as strength of effluent. So that is 65.92 divided by 4. So that is 16.48 milligrams per liter. So this is the concentration of BOD if we are using second stage filter. So how much did we get for first single stage filter? It was 30.22. So obviously if we are using two stage filter, then it gives more treatment, and the BOD which is remaining is further reduced to almost half the value. So this is enough for trickling filter. I think you understood. Thank you.